Greenheck, building value in air.
Hello, I'm Mike Carter, an application engineering specialist for Greenheck.
This video will cover the process of arming the fire system on the fire-ready range hood. The task of installing, arming, and testing the fire suppression system is typically one of a fire suppression distributor. Though the suppression tank is factory mounted in the hood, it is still the responsibility of the distributor hired for the job to inspect the system and ensure it is working as intended. It is important not to adjust the fire suppression system after the initial startup unless authorized to do so. It is highly recommended to have a copy of the Installation and Operations Manual, IOM, on hand before arriving on site. The IOM contains important information regarding the installation, maintenance, and troubleshooting if needed. It also has copies of wiring diagrams that will help in the process of wiring the hood. A copy of this document ships in the product packaging and is also available at greenheck.com. We'll begin with the steps needed to successfully arm the fire system. First, ensure all breakers powering the hood and hood components are on. After the hood is installed, drop the hood into its service position. Remove the black cover from the fire suppression control board enclosure in the left side of the hood by loosening the top thumb nut. You'll see the suppression tank located underneath the fire suppression control board. Make sure the pull pin is installed in the suppression tank. Install the 9-volt battery on the fire suppression control board with the polarity of the battery correct. Notice there is a small negative and positive shown on the battery housing. Start a diagnostic test by first pushing and releasing the reset and then the test button on the left side of the diagnostic board. The test should fail and issue 6 chirps, indicating that the pull pin has not been removed from the tank. If instead you hear a lesser number of chirps, followed by the series of 6 chirps, then some item other than the pull pin has failed and the system should be troubleshot before proceeding further. Please see our other video on troubleshooting for more information or consult the section on troubleshooting in the IOM. Verify the disconnect is powered and all burners on the range are off. Remove the wing screws that hold the fire suppression board enclosure in place. Without disconnecting any cables, expose the agent tank by sliding the control board assembly towards the middle of the hood and down so it's next to the tank. Check and make sure the solenoid release lever is engaged and holding the release latch up, then carefully remove the pull pin from the suppression tank. Insert the pull pin into its socket on the control board. Once the pin is removed, the fire system is armed, so pay close attention when performing this step as an error here may result in a fire system discharge. Next, push and release the reset button on the control board. If you see a green light, leave the pull pin in the circuit board socket. If not, refer to the IOM for troubleshooting. For final verification, unlock the range via the touchscreen, turn on a range burner, then push and release the test button. If there are no failures detected, the fire suppression board will run a shutoff sequence. The alarm will sound for 10 seconds and shut off power or gas to the range, followed by a chirp every minute. This allows complete system verification, but without the chemical agent release. Reset the control board by pressing the reset button and confirm the green indicator momentarily lights up. Make sure all burners are off, then unlock the range via the touchscreen. If a fire system puff test is required, a test tank like this one can be provided. These tanks are only for test purposes and are charged with nitrogen. The purpose of a puff test is to demonstrate proper fire suppression operation. Authorized Guardian distributors and installers should have a G616 test tool that is used to simulate a system activation. Note that a remote pull station option will also serve the same purpose for testing. Install the pull pin from the test kit into the factory installed charge suppression tank, then remove the tank. Install the test tank, re-establishing the appropriate electrical connections. Remove the pull pin from the test tank while ensuring the solenoid release lever is engaged and holding the release latch up. Connect the test tool to the two-pin connector labeled Remote Pull on the control board. Alternately, you can use the remote pull station if the hood was supplied with one. Raise the hood back to its normal location. Press the red button on the test tool or pull the pull station lever to simulate a fire. As we just observed, the test tank has depressurized due to the system's activation of the solenoid latch on the tank. The disconnect has also shut down the electric or gas range disconnect. Additionally, if the system is tied to a building alarm panel, a signal is sent to trigger its activation. Please see our video on hood operation for further details on this. After testing is complete, follow the instructions in the IOM and covered earlier in the content of this video to rearm the hood fire system. And as a reminder, always make sure the solenoid release lever is engaged and holding the release latch before removing the pull pin from the tank. For routine maintenance of the suppression system, inspect the tank and verify charge on a monthly basis. Recertify the suppression tank annually, and every 10 years or after a fire, replace the suppression tank. You have now successfully completed the arming and testing of the fire suppression system of a Greenheck fire-ready range hood. For more information about Greenheck, visit greenheck.com. You can also contact our technical support team at 1-800-371-6858. Thank you for choosing Greenheck.